प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द कंडीशनल कंस्ट्रक्ट. इन द कंडीशनल कंस्ट्रक्ट वी हैव द इफ इफ एल्स देन स्विच केस. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट कंडीशनल कंस्ट्रक्ट वी आर यूजिंग. इट इज यूज व्हेन ए वेरिएबल नीड्स टू बी कंपेयर विद द मल्टीपल वैल्यू टू मेक द डिसीजन. इट्स जस्ट लाइक यू आर सर्चिंग सम काइंड ऑफ कंटेंट ऑन योर बुक. So you are searching some kind of content on your book, so that is you can represent in the switch case also. You can say it till once you are when you are searching for some kind of topic on your book, and after getting the topic, then there is no need to go for searching. Suppose if I am asking that Sri, that you have to bring the chocolates for me, so you are searching where the chocolates are there. You are freeze and in your what the where you store your chocolates. So after getting the specific chocolates, then your searching is stopped. So you are give it to me. The switch case in the conditional part is just like that. You have to give the value. The value is stored in a switch statement, and it will check with the multiple case statement. So what is the value I have given? That value is matched with the every part case statement. So when your value is matched with any case statement, then the corresponding statement is executed, and there we are using a break statement. The work of break is what? If you got your answer, there is no need to go for searching again. The break statement appears when we get the result after I am searching the record from the list, and there is another statement in the switch case it has, that is called as the default statement. The default statement is executed when there is no case statement is matched. So if there is no case statement has matched, then the default case statement is executed. Okay, like you are searching, I am asking that you have to give me the ice cream for the choco flavor. So if that flavor is not available, then what is the other flavor is present, like vanilla or other flavor that you have to give it to me, or butterscotch. Okay, so that flavor you have to give it to me. So that is called the default statement. So in the switch case, the value you have taken, if it is not matched with any case statement, then your default statement is executed. Got it?
No, I don't get it. I don't get the first one.
First line. Okay, so I explain here in the coding part. Okay. Suppose I am asking you that for a chocolate, for a choco flavor chocolate. Okay, so here in the switch expression, I have mentioned I want choco flavor chocolate. Then choco flavor ice cream. Okay, suppose you take that ice cream as input. So I am giving the flavor that I want, choco flavor. Then you have to check. So these are the what case statement is present, where you have take my order or take my what wish, and you have to check whether that choco flavor ice cream is available or not. So where you have to check? You have to check with the case one, case two, and case three, case four. So there is four flavors are available with you. Then you have to check the choco flavor with all the case statement, case 1, case 2, case 3, 4. Suppose the flavor I want it present in the case 3, then the statement in the case 3 that is executed, means you found on the third square or in the third part your ice cream is available. So you take it and you have to give me. And after you get, or after your searching is over, then there is no need to go to the fourth statement because you got your answer in the third one. So there is no requirement to go to the fourth. Then if I'm asking for choco flavor and you have the four option, in that four option, if the flavor that I am asking for, if it is not present, then there is a default statement is present. This statement is present, which is gives you that this flavor is not available. You have to take the vanilla flavor. That is the default. Means if anybody is asking any flavor, if that flavor is not available, then determined you give as a default. So that is called as a default statement. Understood now?
So,
now it is clear?
Yes, I understand.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm showing you another example which makes you clear on that, how it is actually working. Day of a week. So as we know, the day is start from, there is a 7 days, which is starting from 1 to 7. And if anybody is given that there is a 8 day, so 8 day is not available. So here it is asking you that you have to take the input from the user, or you have to take the number from user between 1 to 7 and show the corresponding day. So if you pass 1, then it is giving you like Sunday. If you pass 2, then Monday, then Tuesday. Okay, so similar way this thing is going on. If you are passing the 8th number of day, so 8th number of day is not available. So that it call, it is what? Default day. Okay. Or it is a invalid entry that you have given.
Okay.
Now check that for taking the user input. So we have to take a number from a user. 1 to 7. So 1 to 7 is a numeric value. So that here we define numeric n num. So it is asking you enter a number. Suppose I'm given here 2. So accept 2, begin. The value I have taken 2, it is matched with here. Case 1, no, it is not matched. Case 2 is that value I have given that is matched with the case 2. So it is display you Monday. So after getting the Monday, means I have given the value 2. Then after giving me result, there is no need to go for checking the other condition, case 3, case 4, 5, 6, 7, because I got the answer in the case 2. So it display me here Monday, then break is appear, which is stop for the searching. Suppose it is asking me a number, I have entered here 8. Now the condition, the 8 number will switch and it is matched with the case statement case 1. Case 2, case 3, case 4, 5, 6, 7. Then up to 7, there is no match. So if it is not match, then the default statement is executed because I have passed here 8.
Excuse me. Your screen is paused and I cannot hear you. So no, you like are frozen. I can't hear you. Let me type in the chat.
Yeah. I'm not getting properly you. Just a minute. Now I'm present.
Hello?
It is clear now?
Hello? I'm gonna leave the meeting and come back. Hello? I'm gonna leave the meeting and come back.
Okay.
Hello?
I'm clear?
You're clear now.
Okay. So here what happened, if I pass the number 8, if I pass the number 8, then it is matched with the case statement. Case 1, if it is matched, no. Case 2, will it match? No. So it is matched with the every case. Case 1 to case 7. If it is not matched with any case statement, as I have passed here 8, then the default case statement is executed. So default case statement is saying you have entered the number out of range, because we have the 7 days. But when the user has given 8, then it will display the default statement. It will only validate the number that you give from 1 to 7. If you pass 1, then it is showing you Sunday, 2, Monday, 3, Tuesday. So up to 7, it will display all the days. Is it clear?
Yes, it is clear.
Now it is another program that you have to design the calculator program. Okay, it is very interesting. Okay, so you have to take the value like plus, minus, multiplication, and division. So these are the value we have to take, and based upon the character, we do the operation. Suppose if the user is passing the plus, then it is adding a number, minus, it is subtracting the number. Star for multiplying the number, divide for divide the number. But now we go for it. It is a pseudocode to accept the two number and any one of the operator like plus, minus, multiplication, and division. Based on the operator entered, the pseudocode should add, subtract, multiply, or divide the number and display the result. Then how you have to mention? We define a pseudocode. The pseudocode is starting from begin. Numeric, number 1, number 2, and result. So three location we have created here. Number 1, number 2, and result. So for the three value, four value. Three for the taking the number, another is for taking the character. So we are taking the two number, that is 20 and 14. Then it is asking you display enter any one of the character. So from plus, minus, multiplication, and division, we have to take one value, one character, that is plus, we have taken here. Then the value that we are accepting, if it is matched, so we are accepting plus. So in the case statement, the character plus is matched, so that it is added the number 20 plus 14, it gives you 34. Clear?
Yes, clear.
Now here I have to take another value. Okay, so 24, 14 is giving you 34 is the result, as we are passing a plus symbol. If you pass multiplication symbol, then it is multiply the number. If you pass division, it is divided number. So if you pass any of the number that is not plus, minus, division, and multiplication, then it is showing you it is the invalid character you have passed. So it display you the invalid character. So default statement is execute when there is no case statement is matched. So when there is no case statement is matched, then the default statement is execute.
Okay.
It is another program. Consider the problem of automated telephone call transfer to the various department of a company. Okay, so when you calling to somebody or a customer care, okay, and toll free number. So it is giving you the instruction, okay, so to whom you have to connect, such as marketing, finance, customer care, and HR and information. So these are the different departments are available. So it is asking you that you have to enter some number and it is moving to that particular department. Suppose if you pass 1, then it is moving to the marketing. If you pass 2, it is moving to the finance. If you pass 3, it is moving to the customer care. If you pass 4, it is moving to the HR. And if you are not passing anything, if you not passing any 1, 2, 3, 4 value, if you pass other value, then it is moving to the other department. Now, check how it will display by using of pseudocode.
Okay.
Again, understood this question. What the question is asking you? A pseudocode to accept the department number for an automated telephone call transfer system for various departments of the company, such as marketing, finance, customer care, human resource, and information. So these are the department you have to handle.
Okay.
Then see there.
Wait, I thought you were building a calculator, right?
My sound is not clear.
No, I thought we were building a calculator, right?
Let me check. My voice is clear?
Yes.
Okay.
So I thought we were building calculator, right? Like we were learning about the calculator, right?
Okay, again I explain it.
No, why did we move on to like what can you explain the transfer and marketing department stuff again, like in the PowerPoint presentation?
Okay. So it is just like a company where when you call to the any department, so it is a intercommunication between a company. Okay, for calling to somebody, or like if you want to call to me in the WhatsApp, so I have a specific number, you have also a specific number. But if you are going to any restaurant or you are going to the hotel for holidays and for connecting to some person, and if in an organization or in a company, suppose the manager want to call the employee. So they are not calling from their mobile. They are calling through the internal communication number. So they, when they press 2, it is forward the calling to the employee department. When it press 3, it is moving to the HR department. So it is a automatic call management system. So there is a only you have to press 1, 2, 3, 4. It is moving to the particular department. So there is no need to write the entire 10-digit or 11-digit contact number to connecting to somebody. You have to pass only one digit. It is moving to the different department. So that So it's saying that if you press 1, okay, if you want to get connected to the marketing department, press 1. So if you want to move your call to the marketing, so you have to press 1. When you want to transfer your call to the finance department, then you have to press 2. And when you have to write or you have pressed the 4, it is moving to the HR department. After 1, 2, 3, 4, if you pass any other number, so there is no such departments are available. So it is showing you the default statement that no such departments are available. Got it?
So when you press 4, when you press 5, it will say, is it available?
It is not available. So it's showing you it is not available. So that you have to mention in the default statement. Because we have the 4 number, that is 4 number are available. 1 number for finance, 2 for customer care, 3 for 1 for marketing, 2 for finance, 3 for customer care, 4 for HR. And after that, no departments are there. So it is showing you no, not available. Okay.
Okay.
So now this information will display what I want to give the input. Suppose I have given here 2. So switch 2, my value is comes to here. So when I give 2, it is accepted in the end call and it is switch here. So switch is checking the value from the case statement. So it will check from the case 1, no, I have given here 2. Then it is the searching is going on. So see that numeric end call, it is allocating a memory for call. Then it move to, it will display this part. If you want to get connected to the marketing, press 1. If you want to connect to the finance department, press 2. If you want to get connected to the customer care department, press 3. If you want to get connected to the HR, press 4, then the call will transfer to the information department. So if you are not passing any number, automatic it is moving to the information department. So accept end call. Suppose I am passing here 3. The switch call, this value now comes to here, begin.
Okay.
Next, case 1. So is the value you are given, it is matched with case 1. So false, so it is disabled. Okay, so it is not highlighted. Then the value you are passing, it is matched with 2. No, the value that you are passing 3, here it is matched. So it is showing you transfer the call to the customer care department. Understood?
Okay. Yes, understood.
So it will display, transfer the call to the customer care department. Then if you pass any other number, like 5, that is display you, transfer the call to the information department. So if you pass between 1, 2, 3, 4, it is moving to the particular department. If you pass other number, it will display the transfer the call to the information department.
Okay.
So it is an automated telephone management system. Clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay. Okay, so next example is consider another example. You need to write a pseudocode that accept a letter from alphabet and check whether it is a vowel or consonant. Now tell me the vowel letter. Which are the vowels?
A, I, E, O, U.
Yes. A, E, I, O, U. Then how you have to represent it in the pseudocode? That you have to accept a letter from the user and check whether the letter is a vowel or consonant. So let's see here. Check. First, our pseudocode is start with begin character C letter, display enter a letter. So it is asking you that you have to enter any letter. Then accept a letter. So you have to accept the letter from the user. If the user is passing any letter like A, E, I, O, U in the form of uppercase or lowercase, upper, lower A, lower E, lower I, lower O, lower U, upper A, upper E, upper I, upper O, and upper U. So in all the case statement, it will display only one result, that is the letter is vowel. So that for if you want to show the same sentence for the multiple case statement, so without writing the letter is vowel in each case statement, so after writing all the thing, then you write one line. So there is no need to write here the number is this letter is vowel, then in the E part, there is no need to write again the number is vowel, because for all these 10 case statement, you have to display the same result. So that here there is no requirement to write the display statement in every case. After write all the case statement, you have to mention here. And apart from A, E, I, O, U, if you pass any other number, then it displays the letter is not vowel. Clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay. Now it is a question for you.
Okay.
Which one of the following statement is used to exit from the switch case after condition specified in the case statement?
Default.
Which one?
Default.
No. Default is used if any case statement is not matched, then default statement is executed.
Oh, that's not what the question means. I thought that's what the question means.
The following statement is used to exit from a switch case. So you don't want to continue after getting your result. So which is it?
Oh, exit. Okay. So I'm not sure about it, but I think it might be break. I'm not sure. Hello?
Which option is correct?
Break.
Yes, it is break. Good. That is a break statement we use if you don't want to continue in the switch case statement, as because after getting a result, so there is no need to go for searching the other case statement. So it is absolutely right.
Okay.
Now we perform some other exercises. So you have to help me to write it. So write a pseudocode to accept the 5 number and to display the highest number here. So now tell me how many variable you have to require.
So 5 variables.
5 variable is required, and for comparison, another variable is required. So you can take the 6 variable here. 5 for 5 to take the 5 number, and another you have to take for the comparison. And for comparing or for conditional checking, which statement is used in pseudocode?
Can you repeat that question, please?
For condition checking, we learn now. For conditional part, we're using what?
The first time.
That is? If, if else, nested if else, and another is last one, what we cover? Switch case. Okay.
Okay.
For conditional checking or for checking a condition, we're using 4 conditional constructs. So in the pseudocode, here for the conditional checking, we have to use the conditional construct that is called as a if else. Now see the answer of this one. Okay, so here we have defined 5 variable: numeric number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, and for comparison, we're taking a temporary variable, that is temp. Then here we accept all the number, accept number 1, accept number 2, accept number 3, accept number 4, accept number 5. So 5 value we have take from user.
Hello?
Yes.
Okay, sorry, just okay.
Then accept the number. Suppose we accept the 5 number. If you take the number, so I have written here in the chat box, see that. For the number 1, for n num 1, I have taken suppose 40. N num 2, suppose I have mentioned here 60. In num 3, suppose I am taking here 20. Then in fourth number, suppose 70. In fifth number, suppose I have taken here 10. Okay, if you see your chat box, in number 1, we have taken here 40. Now, we have to check a condition. The 40 is greater than number 2. 40 is greater than 60. Yes or no?
Yes. No, sorry, no.
no. Then it moves to the else part. So when it is moving to the else part, in temporary, we store the number 2. So temporary is another variable in temporary. So in the temporary, we store number 2. So what is the value of number 2?
The value of number 2 is 60.
Is 60. So now in temporary, we store 60. Mm-hmm. Now condition has false. Condition is end here. Now again, another condition it will check. So here we check number 3 is greater than number 4. In number 3, which value has stored? In number 3? What is the value of number 3? Hello.
Oh wait, sorry.
What is the value of number 3? It is 20. Now you have to check here. 20 is greater than number 4. Number 4 value is
4. Actually, I cannot see the chat anymore. It says your internet connection is unstable.
I'm not able to hear you properly. This is a little bit unstable. So it is number three value is 20. And number 4 value is 70. So 20 is greater than 70. The condition is false here. So 20 is not greater than 70. Now it comes to here. Your number three value is greater than temporary. Number 3 value is 20. 20 is greater than temporary. Temporary value is what?
I'm not sure.
60? Yes or no?
No. Yes.
So 20 is greater than 60. No?
No. Actually, I cannot see the chat because it says my internet connection is unstable.
Okay. I repeat it again. Okay. So check here. Earlier, I have stored in number 1, I have passed 40. Number 2 is 60. Number 3 is 20. Number 4 is 70. Then number 5 is 10. So these are the 5 value I have passed here. Okay? Then, here, first, I have checked the condition. Number 1 is greater than number 2. What is the value of number 1?
The value of number 1 is 20.
40. So 40 is greater than number 2. What is the value of number 2?
60.
The 40 is greater than 60?
No.
No, condition is false. So if condition is false, then it is moving to the else part. So here it is, this part is not executed. So it is moving to the else part. In else part, your in temporary, the number 2 has stored. So what is the value of number 2? Number 2 is
number 260.
60. So it's saying that you have to store number 60 into temporary. So I store the number 60 into temporary variable. So here I have mentioned temporary equals to 60. Okay.
Yeah.
Now this part is over. Now it will come to again another condition. Number 3 is greater than number 4. So what is the value of number 3?
Number 3.
See the chat box. What is the value of number 3?
I cannot see the chat box.
Number 3 is?
I cannot see the chat box.
You are unable to see? Open your chat box.
No, it says there's an unstable internet connection. Wait, let me leave and try again on second. Be right back.
Okay, so yes, again I copy this value. So see your chat box. Now it is visible.
Yes, yes. So number 3 is 20.
Number 3 is 20. The 20 is 20 is greater than number 4. Number 4 value is?
Number 4 value is 70. No, it's not greater.
70. So 20 is greater than 70.
No.
No, condition has false. Then it is, this part is totally false. Then it is going to the else part. Then number 4 is greater than temporary. Number 4 value is?
Number 4 value is 70.
70. So 70 is greater than temporary. Temporary value is?
Temporary value is 20.
Here, last one. End temporary. End temporary. End temp value is?
The value is 5.
Here, end temp value is?
Wait, which one? And can you point to it like with your mouse?
It is 60. So number 4 value is 70 and NTEMP value is 60. So 70 is greater than 60.
No.
70 is greater than 60. No.
Oh, wait, yes, it is. I thought you said the other way around.
Okay. Now in temporary, in NTEMP, in NTEMP, the latest value has stored, that is 70. NTEMP, 70 has stored. Now, again, it comes to last condition. In last condition, it has checked. The number 5, what is the value of number 5 now?
Number 5 is 70.
Number 5, here. Number 5?
Number 5 is 10.
10. So 10 is greater than, what is the value of NTEMP?
It is 70.
It's 70. So 10 is greater than 70?
No.
No, condition has false. So when condition has false, so this part is also false. This begin and end part is false. But now it display the highest number is NTEMP. So in NTEMP, what is the value is there?
70.
70. So see that we are passing. In number 1, we have passed 40. In number 2, we have passed 60. In number 3, we have passed 20. Number 4, we have passed 70. Number 5, we have passed 10. So between these 5 numbers, we have written the question that it will gives you the highest number. So when it is showing you the highest number is temporary. So in the temporary, we have stored 70. So 70 is the highest number between 40, 60, 20, 70 and 10. Got it?
Yes, got it.
This program is clear, or again I repeat?
This program is clear, yeah.
Okay, fine. Can you help me in this question? Let's see. Write a pseudocode to accept hours and number of resources and display the total number of productive hours. So it has also given the formula. The total number of productive hours equals to hours into number of resources. It is a formula.
Okay.
So first, what to write in pseudocode?
First we have to write begin.
Begin. Then how many variable is required here? How many variable is required?
24, 25.
How we
24 hours in a day, right? And then the productive hours, and then there's one more for like the thing.
One is to give the productive hours, another variable is required for taking the hours, another variable is required to take number of resources. So here we require
so many hours, right?
Here we require the 3 variable. Okay. So let's check here. Numeric n hours for taking the number of hours, n resources, the number of resources we have to take, and another is productive hours. Then accept hours, then accept resources. First, we accept the hours, accept the resources. Then, for computing the value, we are using here compute. So, you may write or may not write, it is not required. You can directly write also n productive hours equals to n hours into n resources. So, it is multiplied and it is giving you the productive hours.
Okay.
Clear it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it is the simple one, but in programmatically, you have to write a pseudocode to accept the 3 number and display the number in ascending order. Write a pseudocode to accept the 3 number. To display the number in ascending order. So how many variable is required here?
4, I think.
Tell me again.
4.
Yes. Now check. How you have to check? You can take 4, you can take 3 also. So,
Hello.
Huh, tell me.
Nothing. You were just not talking.
Yes.
Excuse me, may I go to a bathroom, please?
Yes, yes. Yes.
Okay, yeah, I'm back.
So this is used for, you have to take the three number and show it in the ascending order. So for the three number, randomly we take, suppose, check your chat box. In num1, suppose we have taken here 50. In num2, suppose we have taken here 20. Then num3, here we have taken here 60. So three number we have take here. So if your number one is greater than number two, if your number one is greater than number two, check, number one is 50. Number two is?
Number two is, wait, is it in the chat? Let me check. Number two is 20.
20. So 50 is greater than 20?
Yes.
And number two is greater than number three. Means number two is 20. 20 is greater than 60.
20 is greater than 60? No.
No. Means first condition is our true, second condition is false. That means in the AND operator, if one condition is false, so it is written you false. Okay, so this statement is false. Now it is going to the next statement. In the next statement, it will check here, number two is greater than number one.
Number two is greater than number one, yes.
No, what is the value of number two?
Number two is 50, I'm pretty sure. Wait, no, it's 20, so it's not 50.
Number two is 20. The 20 is greater than 50.
No.
And your number one is greater than number three. 50 is greater than 60.
No.
Again, so both, both condition is false. So false, false, it return you false. So it is not match. Now comes to another condition. Number three is greater than number one. What is the value of number 3?
It's 60.
So 60 is greater than 50.
60, yes.
So here it is true.
Yes.
And number 1 is greater than number 2.
No. Yes, yes, it is.
Number 1 value is?
Number 1 value is 50.
So 50. 50 is greater than. What is the value of number 2?
Number 2 is 20.
So 50 is greater than 20?
Yes.
So true, true. Both are true. Though in the AND operator, if both are true, it return you true. If both are true, it return you true value. Now here your condition is true. Then it is display you fast. Number 2. What is the value of number 2?
The value of number 2 is 20.
Then it is display number 1. What is the value of number 1?
The value of number 1 is 50.
Then what is the value of number 3?
The value of number 3. The value of number 3 is 60.
60. Now check. Your value is present in the ascending order or not? First, it is display what?
First, it displays 50.
See that. First, it is display 20. Then 50. Then 60. So, all the numbers are present in the ascending order. Yes or no?
Yeah. Yes.
So, this logic, it is helping you to take the 3 number from user and show it in the ascending order. Okay?
Okay. Okay.
It is clear? This program is clear?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Now, next question. Write a pseudocode to accept the age of the user. Then display the category of the user based on the age. The category of the user are, if it is 5 to 12, if it is 5 to 12, it is showing you it is children. 13 to 19 is called as a teenager. 20 to 35, if you pass any age, then it is showing you young adults. 36 to 45 is called as the mature adults. Then 46 to 55 is called as the elders. And 56 and above, it is called as the senior. So these are the basic age range that we have passed. And based upon that, we have to check the age that you have to take from the user or person. They belong to which category?
Okay.
Now move to the pseudocode here. Do you love the outer game? Outer game?
No.
So what are the games you are playing inside the room?
What do you know what kind of games I'm playing inside?
Only video game and mobile games.
Yeah.
Which game is now your favorite?
I don't have favorite.
You are not having any favorite game?
No.
Okay. Now we have to compare. You have to take the age, numeric n age, then accept age. Suppose we have take the n age equals to n age equals to suppose 34. The passing year n age equals to 34. The user is passing the age is 34. It is accepted. Now the condition has checked. The age you have entered 34 is greater than equals to 5.
Yes.
The age is less than equals to 12.
Yes.
34 is less than or equals to 12.
34.
34 is less than 12.
Yes.
So listen mindfully. 34 is less than 12.
No.
So here your 34 is greater than 5, and your 34 is not 34 is not less than your 12. So here condition is false. When condition is false, it is going to the else block. In the else block, it will again check. Is your age? So age we are passing 34. 34 is greater than equals to 13.
Yes.
And the 34 you have passed, that is less than equals to 19.
That is over 19.
34 is less than 19.
No.
So here also your condition has false. So we have already we have to again check it whether the program is available or not. Now we are past 34. The 34 is greater than 20.
Yes.
Now check the 34 is less than equals to 35.
Less than
34 is less than or equals to 35.
Less than, right?
Yes. Then it will display the user is a young adult. Okay, the user is a young adult.
Okay.
Just now we start with the looping part. The looping is a statement. If you want to execute one statement for more than one time. Suppose if I'm giving you task that you have to collect your friend information like their number and their contact number. So if you have the 10 friend for storing the 10 friend information, you have to write 20 line. For one student, for one friend, you have to write 2 line. Similar way, for 10 student, you have to write 20 line. So looping is a sequence of instruction that is repeated more than once. Means you have to repeat a single statement more than one time. So that is called as the repetitive part. A loop must always perform certain step in a specified sequence. So there are 3 type of looping we are using. One is for loop, while loop, and repeat until. So looping is used to execute one statement for more than one time. Okay. For applying the repetition part, we are using 3 looping construct. So how to apply? For applying the looping, we have the 3 structure. One is your for loop, another is your while loop, another is your do while loop. Okay, so this is the types of looping we are using, or types of looping construct we are using. But your looping is of 2 types. One is fixed loop, another is another is variable loop. The looping is of two type. So there is a 2 type of looping we have. One is fixed loop, another is variable loop. Fixed loop means where the number of repetition is known. Suppose I am giving you task that Sridhar, you have to find out all the number from 1 to 10. So we know that for 10 time our statement will execute. So that it is called as the fixed loop. The in fixed loop, the number of the number of repetition is known. And in variable loop, the number of repetition unknown. Okay, like fixed loop means if I am giving you a task that you have to find out all the number from 1 to 10, then you know that your looping will execute from 1 to 10. Variable loop means where the number of repetition is unknown. Suppose I am giving you task that you have to collect the information for the customers. Those are want some specific mobile, Apple mobile. So we don't know in advance how many people will like that particular feature. So when they like, they purchase it. The variable loop is like that. The number of repetition is unknown. Fixed loop means where the number of repetition is known. So for applying that looping, we're using three looping construct. One is one is for loop. Yes, another is for loop, then while loop.
Okay.
Then you go for repeat until. So these are the three looping construct we are using. We can say it is called as the looping construct. So three looping construct is used, means it is the three way to connecting your looping. That is your for loop, while loop, and repeat until. And when anybody is asked you how many loops are there, so your loop is three type. One is fixed loop, the number of repetition is known. Another is variable loop, the number of repetition is unknown. And for applying that looping, we are using three looping construct. One is for loop, while loop, another is repeat until. Got it? Hello?
Yes, hello?
Understood this one? It is clear?
Yeah, got it. Yeah, it's clear.
Okay. Then for loop, it provides a compact way of specifying the statement that control the repetition. So when you repeat a statement, so there should be a control is there, neither it is repeated. Suppose you are moving in a what circle, so if you are not stopping it, suppose I am giving it a task that you have to just run in a ground, in a circle ground, for 5 times. If I'm not giving you timing, then what infinitely it is working. Okay, like when you wash your clothes in washing machine, you are giving a timing. So if you are not giving a timing, then it is continuously it is going on. The for loop is just like that. To looping means the repetition is going on. So for controlling that loop, were using your some kind of conditional statement. So it is So it is provide a compact way of specifying the statement that control the repetition of the step within the loop. So this for loop contains the three part. One is initialization expression, test expression and increment and decrement. First, you have to initialize the value, means store the value in a variable. Then you have to check a condition, means the value that you are passing, it is greater than or smaller. So you have to pass your condition till your condition is true. Till your condition is true, the statement within the for loop is executed. For controlling the loop, we are using some kind of condition. So in the for loop, first we go for initialization. Second, we go for checking condition. So if your condition is true, then the statement within the loop will execute. If your condition has false, then there is no statement is executed. So in the for loop, it will display all the records. Okay, by giving a condition. So for loop contains the three part. If you move to the for loop. So when you define a for loop, it contains a three part. First part is called as the initialization. Next is checking condition. Third part is increment. Yeah. Increment and decrement. Yes, so here we are using semicolon. So when you pass the for loop, it contains the three part and every part is ended with a semicolon. Initialization, checking condition, then here we are using increment and decrement part. Then you write here begin and end statement. Okay. So it is called as the syntax of looping, or what you can say, it is a formula of looping. First you go for initialization, checking condition, then increment and decrement is happened. Okay. Sri, got it? This one? Or any problem?
Got it.
Okay.
No problem.
So here we covered about some exercises based upon the conditional construct. Then after we have started the looping statement. Looping is used to execute one statement for more than one time. To repeat one statement for more than one time, we are using looping. So there is a confusion in mind that when anybody is asked, then we say that the looping is of three type, that we are calling as it is a for loop, while loop, and repeat until. But actually, the looping is of two type. One is fixed loop, another is variable loop. Fixed loop means where the number of repetition is known. Okay, like if you find out the numbers between 1 to 10, then you know that the 10 time the repetition is going on. If I'm given a task that you have to store all the information of the customers they are applying for the online transaction, so you don't know in advance how many customer will order the products. So at runtime they are ordering, then I capturing all the value. So that thing you represent in the variable loop. And for applying this looping, we're using three looping construct. One is your for loop, another is your while loop, another is your repeat until, or you can say it is called as the do while loop. Okay, there is a three looping construct we have. Okay.
Okay.
So in next class, we I have to show you how to write the problems by using of this for loop. Okay, so see these notes, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.